The topic for today is projection geometry from oral radiology. Now this is a very important topic from your oral radiology and from your exam point of view that you should know what is this projection geometry and what are the principles of it. So starting off with the topic, now intraoral radiograph, they are the two-dimensional image. So the radiographs that you're taking, the x-rays that you take is a two-dimensional image of a 3D structure. It is the two-dimensional image of the three-dimensional structure. So at tooth, it is a three-dimensional structure, which is one of the limitation in the dental radiography. So this is the, and because of this, we are seeing that object localization, which I have already covered. Because of this limitation only, we are doing object localization. So thus, it is important to obtain radiograph of highest quality by simple principle of projection geometry. So it is important to get a good radiograph by this principles of projection geometry. Now what they are, I'm going to explain. So what are the principles of shadow casting? So goal of taking radiograph is to record the image of the teeth and the surrounding structure so that they are accurate in size, free from distortion, and they are correctly positioned or proportionate. So basically, what is the goal of taking a good radiograph? So it is all the structures that you are taking the radiograph of, they should be recorded accurately in size, they should not be distorted, and they are correctly proportionate. So the position of them, it is proper. So now basically it is like the principle of shadow casting is taking an ideal radiograph. So what is an ideal radiograph? So H.M. Wirth, he defined it as the one which has a desired density or a overall darkness. So density is nothing but how light or dark it is. So H.M. Wirth, he defined it as, it is the one which has desired density and the one which shows the part completely. So the tooth which you are taking the radiograph of, it should be seen completely into a radiograph without any distortion, with maximum details and with the right amount of contrast to make the detail fully apparent. So this is what your ideal radiograph is, and the principles of shadow casting is to get this ideal radiograph. And there are two basic techniques to get this radiographs. So this is bisecting angle technique and paralleling technique. So I'm going to explain these two techniques in the further video, what exactly it is, and the ones which we are using mostly is bisecting angle technique, and how it works I'm going to explain. So basically, now the objective of both the technique, it is to direct the central ray at the most favorable angle through the patient's tissue and onto the film, so that the least distortion and the most accurate representation is obtained. And this is achieved by following six rules of image formation. So these are the six principles. That is, the first is the focal spot, that is your source. So this is a focal spot. Now, as we know, in our X-ray tube, we have an anode and a cathode, and this target is the focal spot through which your X-rays, they are generated. So the focal spot, it should be as small as possible. So this is the first principle. The second principle is the distance between the object and the film, that is your tooth film distance, it should be as small as possible. So the distance between the film and your tooth, it should be small as possible. The third is the object and the film, it should be parallel to each other. So the object and the film, it should be parallel to each other. The third, fourth one is the focal spot, that is the source, tooth distance, it should be as long as possible. So the distance between the tooth and the source, that is the radiation source, that is your X-ray tube, it should be as long as possible. Then the X-ray beam, it should be perpendicular to the tooth and the film. So the beams, your X-ray beams, they should be perpendicular to the tooth and the film. And last is the tooth, it should be positioned in the center of the film, and there should be no movement of the tube or film or the patient during exposure. So these all are the principles of shadow casting. Now the projection geometry, it can be described under following headings. So what headings they are, I'm going to explain. So it is described under image sharpness and image resolution. So what is image sharpness? It is the degree which defines. So image sharpness, it is defined as how well a boundary between two differing radio densities is delineated. So that is your sharpness, how good your radiograph is. And image resolution is, it is the degree which defines how well a radiograph, it records separate objects that are close together. So radio resolution, That is your image resolution is if like on your tooth, now there is enamel, dentine. So how good it records like this two different structures properly, that is your image resolution. So the X-ray, they are divergent in nature. So when they are emitted from the focal spot, so this is your anode, so this is your focal spot. So when the X-ray, they are emitted from this focal spot, they originate from all the points over the focal spot. So this is your focal spot. So they originate from all the point from your focal spot and they diverge or radiate in all the direction. So this is your focal spot and they are directing in all the directions and they pass separately through the edge of the object. So these rays, they originate from different point sources and they pass separately through edge of the object. Thus, different rays from the separate image of the edge of the object at the separate place, and this results in the blurring because now this is your focal spot and this rays, they are divergent, and when they are like originating, so they are getting dispersed, and because of that there is blurring of the image, and this blurring of the image is known as penumbra. So first I'm going to explain what exactly this penumbra, because we will see like we are applying this penumbra in every principle. So umbra, it is the area on the film that represents the image of the tooth. So this is your tooth, this is your focal spot. Now as we have seen, your X-ray, they get diverged, and because of this the rays which are produced, they are scattered, and when this X-ray, they hit the tooth and they create this image, and this image is known as umbra. So this image is known as umbra. But penumbra, it is the area around the umbra. So this is umbra and the area around this is the penumbra. Penumbra is nothing but in Latin, it is known as, pen is known as almost, and umbra, it is known as shadow. So this is almost like a shadow. So penumbra, it is the area around the umbra. It is the zone of unsharpness, that is the blurring. So penumbra is nothing but the blurred image. And more the penumbra, less sharp will be the image. So our aim is to get as small as penumbra that is possible. So starting off with the first principle, that was use as small as possible the focal spot. So the focal spot, that is the source of radiation, the source of radiation, it should be as small as possible. Now in this image, now when you're using a large focal spot, so when the rays are generated, so over here as you can see the area of the unsharpness is more. So over here, now as we have seen, it gets originated like from all the points from the focal spot. So because of that, the area of unsharpness is more when the focal spot is larger. But now, and as we are reducing the size of the focal spot, now over here, as you can see, the area of the sharpness, it is reducing. So you can compare it with these two. So the area of sharpness, it was more when the focal spot, it was large, and over here, it is small. So this is the first principle, that is using as small as possible the focal spot. And in the case of point source, that is if the focal spot is a point type, then there is no sharpness or there is no penumbra which is produced. And ideally the focal spot, it is 0.4 mm to get the best image. So this is basically the same thing. So this black one is the umbra and around it is penumbra. So this is your tooth, this is the object, and this is a focal spot. So if the focal spot is small, over here as you can see, there is less amount of penumbra. But when the focal spot, it is larger, so there is larger amount of penumbra. So this was the first one. The second is the distance between the focal spot and the tooth, it should be large. So what is the purpose of it? So it is to reduce the divergence of the rays. So as we know, now when the rays are produced, they get divergent. So the purpose of it is to reduce the divergence of the ray. As the distance between the source and the teeth, it increases, the image becomes more sharper and less magnified. So in this diagram, now the distance between this source, so this is your X-ray tube head and this is your tooth. So the distance between these two, if it is small, then there is more unsharpness. So there is more penumbra, or the image, it is more magnified. But now when the distance between the source and the tooth, it is larger. So here, as you can see, the distance, it is larger. So there is less unsharpness which is produced, and because they are getting less divergent. So this is the second principle, that was the distance between the focal spot and the tooth, it should be large. The third one is the tooth film distance, it should be small. So in this diagram, now you can see, this is your focal spot, this is your tooth. So it says the tooth film distance, it should be small. So this is the film, and the film and the distance between the tooth, it should be small so that you get good image. Now if the distance between the film and the tooth, it is increased, now you can see over here the image, it is more magnified, so the sharpness and the clarity of the image, it is hampered. So the distance, so the closer the proximity of the tooth to the film, lesser the image enlargement. So this is what the third principle says, that is tooth film distance, it should be small to prevent the enlargement of the image. Then the next one is the object and the film, it should be parallel to each other. So this is the film, this is the film holder over here. Now this is the film holder, this is the film, and this is the tooth, that is your object. So the object and the film, it should be parallel to each other. So when you are placing your film, it should be usually parallel to each other. And this, it comes under image size distortion. To prevent the image size distortion, this is the principle that we follow, that the image, that the object and the film, it should be parallel. So basically all the three principles that we have seen, it is for the image sharpness and the resolution. Now this principle, it is basically for the image size distortion. So this is what we see, the position of the image receptor, it is parallel to the long axis of the object. Now the next is, so basically it minimizes the distortion of the image. And these are the two paralleling and the bisecting angle technique that we use to take the radiograph, which I'm going to explain. So this is the way a bisecting, the film is placed in a bisecting angle technique, and this is a paralleling technique, which I'm going to explain in detail. The next one is the X-ray beam, it should be perpendicular to the tooth and the film. So over here, now your X-ray beam, so the source over here, if this was a source, so the X-ray beam, when it is generated, it should be perpendicular to the long axis of the tooth and to the film. So this is the long axis of the tooth and this is your film. So when the rays, they are generated, now over here, as you can see, they should be perpendicular to it. So this is the fifth principle, and again it helps in the image size distortion. And the next is image shape distortion. So what happens in image shape distortion is, so image shape distortion, it is the unequal magnification of the different parts of the same object, and it is also called as dimensional distortion. So basically it's like uneven magnification. So there can be like different troubleshooting in this case. If it is not properly placed, if your image receptor or your object, it is not placed properly, so there can be foreshortening, elongation and overlapping. So what is foreshortening? Foreshortening is if the film, it is not placed parallel to the object. Now in this case, now over here, as you can see, the film, it is not placed parallel, but now it is angulated. So in this case, the film, it is not parallel, but the central ray, that is your X-ray, it is perpendicular to the film, and because of this, there is the recorded image, the size of this recorded image, it is shortened. So this is the foreshortening. When it is not parallel, it will lead to the shortening of the image. So there is this foreshortening. The next is elongation. So in this case, if the film, it is not placed parallel to the object and the central ray is perpendicular to the object only. So now in this case, this was the first case. Now in this case, it was, when does foreshortening occurs? It is when the film is not parallel and your X-ray, central X-ray, it was perpendicular to the film only. So when this X-ray, it was perpendicular to the film, so there is foreshortening. Now in the next scenario, it's like, again, the film is not parallel and the central ray, it is perpendicular to the object only, but it is not perpendicular to the film. So film, it is angulated in second scenario. Because of that, there is elongation of the image. And the third scenario is this overlapping. So overlapping, if the film and the object, they are placed, so if the film over here, this is the film, for example, this was the film, and the object, it is placed parallel to each other, but now your central ray, it is not perpendicular to either of them. So in that case, there will be overlapping. And these are the, like, the troubleshooting which will affect the image quality, which we don't want, the X-ray quality. Now the last one is the tooth, it should be positioned in the center of the film. So now in this case, if this is the second molar, which is the tooth in question, and we want a good radiograph of the second molar. So now when you're placing the film, it should be positioned in the center of it. So the distance on the either side, it should be equal. So it is like D1 is equal to D2. And because of this, you'll get a good radiographic image. Now over here, as you can see, your premolar, it is completely seen. And the distance between these two, like the distance over here and the distance over here, it is equal. So basically it is the tooth, it is positioned in the center of the film. Now we have seen all this in the principles of your projection geometry. And this is like very important, and we apply this projection geometry principle in this bisecting angle technique and paneling angle technique, which I'm going to explain. So this was it. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you have any doubts regarding this, then do let me know in the comment section. Thank you so much.